All right, so welcome back. In the previous video, we kind of walked through the theory behind state machines, as well as kind of mocked up what our state machine is going to be for the purposes of our character. We're back inside Unreal now. We're actually going to create that state machine here together. So to do that, we need to have the character animation blueprint open, which I currently do. If you do not, you can go to the content browser and under character, double click and open the character animation BP, and when you open it, it will open to the graph tab of Persona. And once you're inside the graph tab of Persona, make sure that you are on the animation graph of the animation blueprint editor here, as that's where we're going to create our state machine. So inside the graph section here, we're going to right click and search for state. And under state machines, there's the option to add new state machine. So go ahead and select that. And first thing we're going to do before we do anything else so that we don't forget, this is the resulting pose from our state machine that we want to connect to our final animation pose that we see in game. So go ahead and left click and drag from this little standing dude here and connect him to the result. Now, once we've done so, actually, before we forget, let's rename our state machine to something better than new state machine. So go ahead and select the node. It should give you the option to rename it. If it doesn't, you can hit F2 or do it inside the details panel down here. Let's go ahead and rename this to Locomotion. That's going to throw up a warning. Don't worry about that. That's because there's nothing inside of our state machine yet. Let's actually populate our state machine. So go ahead and double click on the Locomotion node. As you can see, as I mouse over it, there's another graph inside of it. So let's go ahead and double click and open it. And you can see we have an entry point. Now, what we need to define is our default pose, our default state to enter. And if you recall, I'm actually going to pop this up really quickly, our PowerPoint here. If you recall, we determined that we want to have an idle walk run state, which handles, as the name suggests, our idle walk and run animations. And then we also have our jump start, we have our jump loop, and our jump end. So our entry point is going to enter into this idle walk run state. So let's go ahead and create that first. So we'll hop back to Unreal here. And we can do you can do it a number of different ways. Probably the easiest way is to drag off an existing state and release, and you can add a new state. And go ahead and call it the idle walk run state. Now this by itself doesn't do anything. Again, if I mouse over it, you can kind of see that there's something inside of it that needs to be done. So go ahead and double click on idle walk run. That will open up a new graph. And it's asking for the resulting pose. Now we have created our blend space that kind of gives us different poses based on that speed variable that we created for the blend space. Let me see if I can actually pop that open really quick so you can see that again. So here's our idle walk run blend space that is driven by the speed parameter. So go ahead and inside the graph tab, let me get back to that. Inside of our idle walk run state in the asset browser, go ahead and drag the idle walk run blend space into the graph just by left clicking and dragging and release. And it's going to give us that resulting pose based on our speed variable. So go ahead and drag off the out pose and connect it to the result. Now it's asking for the speed, which we don't know. This is going to be a variable. This is driven by the player characters. So go ahead and right click on speed. And that's going to give us the option to promote that to a variable. So go ahead and select that, promote to variable. Now it's inside the My Blueprint window. It's asking us to name this. Let's go ahead and name this for consistency, speed, like so. So our first state is complete. That's all we need to do right now. There's no other measures that we need to take. Eventually, what we'll want to do is hop over to the event graph. If you recall, this is where the updating occurs. This is where we will update this speed variable to give us the pose that we need, either idle, walking, or running. So let's actually hop to the locomotion tab here. Let's create our next state. So let's drag off of idle walk run here and release and add state. And this is going to be our jump start. go ahead and double click on jump start. And again, it's asking for a pose to be fed. So go down to the asset browser down here and let's grab our jump start animation. So just move this over so we could see. There it is. Third person jump, not loop, but start. Just left click and drag that in and connect the animation pose to the result. And that's all we need to do for our jump start. We can hop back to the locomotion tab. We do need to define that rule. How do we get from idle walk run to jump start? And we said in our quick mockup that we wanted to check if the player character is in air. So let's go ahead and do that. Double click on the transition rule here. And you can see it's asking for a Boolean. And that Boolean is going to be, are we in air? So we can right click on this and promote to variable. And we'll call this new variable is in air. And that's all we need to do for that transition rule. We can hop back to the locomotion tab and continue with our remaining two states. You can move these around however you want just by dragging. You can see the arrow kind of updates to kind of show you the flow of things. So I'm just going to move it up here a little bit. We're going to drag off of jump start now, and we're going to go over to our jump loop. So let's add a state. Call this jump loop. Go ahead and double click and open jump loop. And let's find our jump loop animation in the asset browser. So third person jump loop and drag that in and connect it. Let's go back to our locomotion tab and define that rule. So let's double click and open the transition rule. And for this one, we said, is the player character near the end of the start animation? So when near the end of the jump start, automatically proceed to jump loop. So let's go ahead and do that. And the way we can get to this is pretty easy. Let's just right click and let's search for ratio. And at the top, you can see there's current time ratio for third person jump start. But there's also time remaining ratio. This is the one that we want. So go ahead and select time remaining ratio. And it's giving us a float value. So what we need to do is drag off of this pin here, left click and drag. And let's do a less than symbol. So let's do less than float. And let's do 0.1. And let's connect the Boolean out to the can enter transition. Now for this 0.1, what we are essentially saying is, has there been 90% of the jump start animation that has played? Is there only less than 10% left of the jump start? If there is, then go ahead and enter the jump loop. So let's actually hop back to the locomotion tab. And let's add our final state here, which is, let's add one more state, jump end. And if you recall, for this transition rule, we were saying, is the player character not in the air? If they aren't, then go ahead and proceed to jump end. So let's set that rule. So let's double click on the transition rule. Now we can't just right click on this, or let me go down to the My Blueprint window here, find our Boolean. We can't just drag this and connect it directly. We need to determine if this is not true, because this is asking for a true or false. We need to say, is this not true? So let's just left click and drag our isInAir variable into the graph and release. It's gonna ask for a getter or a setter. We wanna get that variable to get the value of it. And what we want to do is drag off this and search for not. So there you go, not. So is in air, not. And if it is, then we can enter that transition. So we're getting a bunch of tabs up here. You can close these if you want, just by clicking the little X mark to get back to the main locomotion tab. We do need to define the pose for jump in. So go ahead and double click on jump end there. And inside the asset browser, let's get our jump end animation. Left click and drag that in. Let's connect the pose to the result, like so. And go back to locomotion and set up our final transition rule back to idle, walk, run. So just left click and drag, like so. Now for this transition rule, let's double click on it. And again, let's go back to our PowerPoint one more time. Near the end of the end animation. So are we near the end of the end animation? So it's going to be almost identical to the way that we set this up. So let's go back to Unreal. And again, it's ratio that we are looking for. So right click and search for ratio. And there it is, time remaining ratio for third person jump end. So go ahead and select that. And do the same thing for this one. So drag off the float, less than symbol. And we'll set this to 0.1 as well. And then connect. And let's go back to our locomotion one more time. I think we are done setting up the state machine. So let's compile up in the upper left up here. Go ahead and click compile. And once we've done so, you can see that our character is now in our idle walk run state. He is now idling. He still has the dislocated arm, which we'll fix. I promise you we'll fix that in an upcoming video here. But you can see that we are in our idle walk run. And we can actually test this now inside the preview editor here. You can see that our speed is zero, which is why we are idling. But if I move this up, if I just drag this up a little bit, you can see that we start to walk. And if I drag it even more, then we start to run. So that is currently functioning the way that we anticipated. We could also check if we are in air by clicking the checkbox here. Let me zero this out again really quickly. If we click this little checkbox, our character is in air. You can see it actually updating in the graph here as well, which is kind of cool. So if I uncheck, we went to in and we went back to idle walk run. Again, watch this side over here. As I click the check mark, we go to jump start, then jump loop. As soon as we are no longer in the jump loop, we go to jump end and back to idle walk run. Now I'm noticing a little bit of a hitch there in the preview window as I move from jump start to jump loop. You can see it again here. Also on the jump end to idle walk run, we can fix those really easily. I'll show you how to do that here in a second, but see that little hitch? Let's go ahead and fix that really quickly. Let's go into the transition rule for both of these. We'll start with this one here. We're gonna change this duration here from when we can start to move into our jump loop. So currently it's set to 10%. Let's change this to say 0.5. Once I'm halfway through the jump start, then we can enter into jump loop. Let's compile and test that really quickly. So now we're not getting that hitch. It looks a little bit better. Let's do the same thing for the jump end as well. So go back up to the locomotion tab. And then let's also go to this transition rule here. This one, let's try and set this one to, let's set it to 0.5 as well and see how that looks. And compile. Let's test it. A little bit of a hitch on the way down there. You can play with these numbers and get a better looking transition if you'd like. I'll change it to 0.75. Let's see how that looks. And compile. That's better. Again, it's not perfect, but kind of conveys what we want to do. So I think that's it. I think we've created all the states that we need and hooked all of our transitions up. But we do need to, if we hop over to the locomotion tab again really quickly, we do need to define how all of our transition rules are updated. So we're going to do that actually on the event graph up here. So if you remember, the event graph handles and processes all the data coming in frame to frame. So we need to start working on that next. So we're going to pause here and we'll pick up in the next video working on the event graph and finish off our animation blueprint. Thank you guys for tuning in and we'll see you in the next video.